Showdown, the 2012 East Region Playoffs. I am Sasha Victim, and this is a man who really needs no introduction, but he'll introduce himself anyway.
Well, you know my voice. I'm the Reverend Al Mighty. One day in it, but screaming like a banshee, and this is what you're getting at home. Sorry about that, folks.
And you know, this tournament has really been a tournament worth screaming over. It's been a great series of games. Nothing's really been close, but there have been some great plays. Right now, what we're going to be seeing here is a team in Boston that has already played. They defeated DC earlier today, but if it wasn't for the first 10 minutes and the last 5 minutes of that game, it would have been a lot closer against DC, the number 10 seed.
DC was not giving that game away to anybody, and they proved that they're a team that deserved to be at the Eastern Regional Playoffs. I'm glad we were able to see it. They've been around for a long time. It was a great opportunity to see them playing at this level. The first time they've ever played Boston, not just a regional tournament, but ever. So Boston got to get that notch on their belt. But Boston definitely needed to use that game. It probably helped them out a bit to get warm up, figure out what they need to do before they face the perennial champ, the perennial ride to the championships in Philly.
Yeah, and Philly, you know, not only have they been in the final running, in the championship game of the East Region Playoffs for like the last, I believe the last 4 or 5 years, but also they come into this game undefeated since ECDX, and Al, they have not played any slouches. They beat Rocky Mountain 172-116. They beat Rose City 259-101, and they beat Minnesota 189-149. In addition to wins over Columbia and Bear City, Philly is on a roll ever since ECDX. And you know, Al, we need to introduce everyone to the rosters. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Philly?
Well, Philly, we got, of course, coming in with number 6, Castro. We got Antidote. We got V Diva. Came over from Philly. I think
from Dutchland.
Came to Philly from Dutchland last year. Devoid of Mercy, Copper Top, Heavy Flow, Solanitary, Olivia Face, Gloria Grindham, Mo Payne, Teflon Donna, my favorite player in roller derby. I'm going
to
say
hard,
it.
Hard not to have her be your favorite.
Goldie, Gingivitis, and Damage Doll.
And we'll get through the Boston roster in just a second. It is currently Ginger Kid for Boston in the white, jamming against V Diva, 18-18 for Philly in the black. Ginger Kid is through first, and she is lead jammer for Boston.
Ginger Kid had a very exciting bout early against DC. She breaks through the pack, but V Diva is right behind her. V Diva is so strong with her stride. Ginger Kid pulls it through. 1 point up on the board.
One point for the Boston Massacre. And Al, we mentioned the Boston Massacre. Let's talk about them. 101, Anorexia. 103, F, Haley Contagious. 1081, Dixie Kicks. 1111, Maya Mangalgu. 1987, Shark Week. Number 27, Ivana Shankovic, a.k.a. Shank. Number 357, Vixen DeHitcha. 43, we just said her name, Ginger Kid. 451, the highest scoring member of the team against DC. That was Lil Payne. 55, Bad Person. 666, Dottie Danger. 71, Maud Forbid. We'll get to the other two in just a moment.
Payne is out there. She gets lead jammer status almost immediately over Philly's defense. Mo Payne is jamming for Philly. Lil Payne has a huge advantage right now. Mo Payne is definitely trying to make up some of that real estate separating the two, but Lil Payne is back in the pack. Looks over her shoulder, gets a point.
There's the call.
Calls off the jam. No point is scored.
Scoreless jam, but you know what, Al? Holding Philly scoreless is no simple effort. So Boston able to hold them scoreless is a fantastic measure. To go ahead and mention the other two members of the Boston Massacre roster, 859 Salome Splatter and PT78 Speed Metal. Make your Boston Massacre.
And whenever you say Speed Metal's name, you know you have to throw the dragon horns up in the air and go, Speed Metal! It's like a Ronnie James Dio thing.
You know, in between Twisted Scissors and Skid Ho on Dutchland and Speed Metal on Boston, there's a very rock and roll feel at the Sugar Bush Showdown.
They need to have a heavy metal tournament someday. Speaking of which, she is heavy. She is Maya Mangu out there. Beautiful. Outside. Nope, she gets called out.
Major forearm penalty. It is Power Jam Philly. But Ginger Kid with a great hit on number 87, Goldie, sending her out.
Goldie still is not able to make her initial pass. They keep recycling her to the back of the pack. Boston doing a really good job now with taking advantage of a disadvantaged situation.
Yeah, and you know, this is something that Boston's going to need to hang their hat on. Philly, when they're given power GM situations, are extremely difficult to beat.
Last thing you want is the number two team in the Eastern Region to get a huge lead over you by some big power jam, big points. Right there, so far, more than 30 seconds into this penalty, not a point has been scored.
And to give you a little bit of background, the last time a number seven seed defeated a number two seed was the 2010 North Central Tournament, when Minnesota scored the upset and worked their way into champs. So if Boston has been taking a page out of Minnesota's book, we're in for a game, Al.
Looks like they're taking a book out of professional boxing right there, as they boxed her right in, got her going. She wasn't able to even step to the side. Took her a lot. Did get the 5 points, but she had to work for it. Meyer is already back on the pack now for Boston.
30 seconds remaining in the jam here. Philly has retaken the lead, 5-1. Power jam is over as Maya Mangalyu has completed her initial pass out of the penalty box.
Power jam now in favor of Boston. Track cut on Philly, sending the jammer number 87.
That's Goldie.
Goldie off to the penalty box. Maya's now skating there unopposed.
And this is a scoring pass for Maya Mangalyu. 4 points scored. Only 4 points scored. That's going to tie it up, Al. 5-5 with 26 minutes remaining here in the first period. And when we return to action, our next jam will be brought to you by Printco. For your league's printing and promotional needs, hit up printcographics.com.
Little Payton going to be out there starting unopposed on the jammer line in a power jam for Boston. Who would have thought that four jams into it, we would be looking at a score of 7-5 in favor of Philly.
2 points were awarded to Goldie as she went into the penalty box. So Philly does have the lead, 7-5, 25 and a half minutes remaining. It will be Ginger Vitus jam. Oh, I'm sorry. No, it's
Little Payne.
Little Payne is out there for Boston. I saw Ginger Vitus' jersey. She's a blocker out there right now for Philly.
Little Payne swings around the outside, does get through. She is your lead jammer. Little Payne, the highest scoring player for Boston earlier against DC. Rumor has it she's a school teacher. All our kids are watching this right now, rooting on their teacher. Well, that is a cool school.
Well, if you want to mention that, hey, you're being taught by Lil Payne, you can also send a shout-out to us on Twitter. We're using the hashtag talk, the number two, WFTDA, as Lil Payne completes a 5-point scoring pass, Al.
That's a lead change, putting Boston in the lead. 10-7 over Philly. Once again, Boston wearing white, Philly wearing black and blue. Little Payne has that really different style when she goes into the back. She almost goes limp with her arms to ensure that she doesn't incur any penalties and gets the ability to get 5 more points up on the board.
Power jam is over as Goldie has re-entered the fray. Damage doll being sent off for a multiplayer block major penalty.
A lot of quick trips to the box already early on in this bout. Boston had a very, very, very clean game earlier against DC. This is Philly's first time out there today, as we mentioned earlier. They must have had the jitters today, just sitting around watching all this derby, wanting to get out there. And that could be coming out cold, and that may be favoring Boston as another 5 points get up on the board.
That's right. We've only seen VT of a jam once as well. So right now, Philly, I have to say, they've come out of the gate stunned. It's 20-7 right now with Boston in the lead. They're going to need to regroup and quick, because that's another 5 points on the board for Boston. And Little Payne completing a scoring pass.
Little Payne knows that right behind her is Goldie. Calls off the jam. Little Payne showing it up there.
And it's almost like I called her number, because V Diva will be jamming next for the Philly Liberty Bells, number 18-18.
It's a rematch from the first jam against Ginger Kid.
This jam brought to you by Derby Skins, the original shiny hiney, may be imitated but never duplicated. Find them on the web at derbyskins.com, and that's skins with a Z.
And remember, folks, if you want to talk to us from home, check out the Twitter.
You can hashtag talk the number two, WFTDA. Make sure to let Reverend Almighty know how wonderful he is doing, because he's a wonderful, wonderful
as
man.
I stumble over the Twitter line, that's beautiful.
No, because you're doing wonderful. It's all good.
Oh, V-Diva's looking right at me. We're having a moment. Stop it.
Well, while you wave to V-Diva, this is an official timeout right now. The chance of Boston, pinch, permeating the Champlain Valley Exposition, Al. These Boston fans are loud and rowdy right here in Essex Junction, Vermont.
Nothing holds the Boston back there. Wicked smart and wicked awesome and ready to tear it up for you. Big split right there. V-Diva right through. She is your lead jammer. And Heavy flow back there just laying the beating to gingivitis.
Yeah, and V-Diva really is almost the complete package as a jammer out there. She's tall, she's lanky, she's physical, she has great agility. She is the total package out there. You saw right there, she hopped through, almost got tangled up, landed on her feet, completes the four-point scoring pass.
Yep. It's amazing when a big girl can get through little spaces, and V-Diva does it amazingly.
Some incredible agility there. As 4 point score there, Boston retains the lead, 26-11, less than 23 minutes remaining here in the first period. And when we return to action, our next jam will be brought to you by Five Stride Skate Shop, online, in store, in the city that never sleeps, owned by Bonnie Thunders and OMG WTF. Find them on the web at fivestride.com.
Meyer Mengel, you coming up down the line for Boston versus Teflon Don on the first time tonight on the jam line for Philly.
One of your favorites out there, Al.
Teflon Don, and known for that great play, that great time that they beat Gotham. She threw herself past a few players, won the hearts of America on that day, and been stealing it ever since. Both people fighting on the inside. Maya, though, breaks out first. Maya is your lead jammer.
And you know, this is really, I don't think, going the way Philly was anticipating it going. I think, you know, Philly was coming in saying, all right, well, Boston's already played a game, and now they're trailing Boston. This would be a major upset, Al, if this retains.
Absolutely. 7-7 over 2 would be a major upset. Like we said, we haven't seen it since Minnesota in 2010. And I actually heard players from Boston saying that they were going in to use this as a learning tool. And I think they're maybe even surprising themselves. They're coming in. They're learning that they could win this game.
The students are teaching the teacher right now. 28-11 is the score. It will be Antidote jamming for the first time for Philly.
And that is Little Payne.
It's like a 4-on-3 pack advantage for the Boston Massacre.
Little Payne breaks right through, cuts through the middle, untouched. She's your lead jammer.
And Al, I have to wonder, how long will it take before we hear a timeout from the Philly bench coaches, maybe to get things coordinated? Because right now, this is Boston's game to lose.
Absolutely. Philly is allowing that front of that line. No points scored for Philly, 3 for Boston. Philly is allowing the front of that line to be tackled too quickly, and Boston is taking advantage of it.
And you saw Antidote on your screen as she was heading off. She wanted that point, Al, and it was not assessed to her. 31-11 is the score in favor of Boston as V-Diva is up on the line for the Liberty Bells.
And Maya's out there for Boston.
This jam is brought to you by Derbalife, roller derby nutrition at its finest. Find them on the web at derbalife.com.
Maya breaks right through the outside line, untouched. She is your lead jammer.
V-Diva not far behind in the pack. Philly trying to get that front wall, which should force a call off. You don't want V-Diva charging at you.
V-Diva goes down on the outside. She's looking for points. No points scored. They're not giving you the 3, V.
They didn't give it to her because the hips have to pass the hips. While the hips may have come close to passing, you have to completely pass the hips of the opposing blocker. She also went out of bounds in the process. You don't score points when you are out of bounds, Al.
Absolutely. She was sliding to the outside. Her hips were actually behind her. There was no way to score points there.
Scoreless jam there is Teflon Donna, number 85, up on the line for the Liberty Bells.
That's Lil Payne out there for Boston. Or as we'll call her for her students today, Miss Leiter.
And
Teflon Donna right through there now. Lead jammer status for the first time tonight, I believe, for Philly.
Yeah, well, this is the momentum that Philly needed. V-Diva did have a lead jammer status earlier, but this is the momentum Philly needs right now. Boston has shown that in the first 10 minutes they can come out hot. Philly needs to put the brakes on them and cool them down, or this will be an upset.
Slow this game down. I said it before, I believe that Boston really came in at an advantage playing earlier. You know, you think if you're the second seed, you don't have to play a game until 8 o'clock at night, it's a good thing. But Philly's been here most of the day. You got to kind of get a little jittery, get a little cold, your body gets stiff.
Yeah.
There's no training facility here where they're out training, and it becomes very difficult. And Philly needs to definitely get a little loosen up time. Hopefully they've done that, and they're going to come back with this game. We got Ginger Kid coming up there on the line against V-Diva.
And 4 points were scored in the last jam. 31-15 is the score as we have 18 and a half minutes remaining here in the first period.
Ginger right through the middle, and she is your lead jammer again.
And you know, Ginger Kid was really an impressive jammer against DC as well. The fact that they are putting this kind of fight to Philly really shows how much Boston wants to advance and reclaim some of their past glory. The last time they went to championships was 2009, Al.
Got to talk about the big hits that Vixen the Hitcher is putting on V. Deaver out there. There's only a few people I've ever seen out there that have been able to go shoulder to shoulder, bump for bump with V. Deaver. It looks like Vixen the Hitcher's got her name on her.
Our next chant will be brought to you by 5-on-5 Magazine, the Women's Flat Track Roller Derby Magazine, with subscriptions available at 5on5mag.com. It's always in my travel bag, Al.
Little pain out there for Boston in the white versus Teflon Donna out there for Philly in the black and blue.
If you're just joining us, this is Sasha and Victim along with the Reverend Almighty. Philly in the black and blue dresses, Boston in the white with navy blue lettering. And Lil Payne is through once again. Lead jammer status going to the Boston Massacre.
Lil Payne has showed her dominance today through both games. Just comes through 5 points, 4 points up on the board. Calling off the jam.
That is, in fact, 4 points. If you can't believe what you're seeing out there, let us know out on Twitter. Send us a tweet and end it with the hashtag #talk2, WFTDA. Let us know what you think out there. And also, if you have not purchased the video upgrade, if you're out there listening on the audio and you want the video upgrade, it's just $12 for the rest of the weekend. There are still 11 games to go in this tournament, Al.
That's like a $1.10 a game. How do you not get it? And then between the games, you get to see handsome people like Bam Bam and me, the Reverend Almighty. I'm worth $12 to look at.
And moderately ugly people like Sasha and Victim. Back to action here. It's going to be number 8. That is Mo Payne jamming for Philly. But Boston has lead jammer status. That is Maya Mangalyu.
Maya doing an excellent job breaking right through the inside. Right now, Boston is the more physical team against Philly, and that's something I've never seen.
That is a surprise. I think usually you only see, in terms of physical teams, you only see someone match up with Philly when it's Gotham or Charmed City. You don't, and at least in the East region, Boston can be proud of the way they played this first 14 minutes, Al.
Absolutely. Little Payne coming back up onto the line against Antidote for Philly. Boston is right out there every jam. They're trying to play this jam for jam against Philly. Any day, I would tell you that's the wrong way to play it, but they are doing it and winning.
And there is the team timeout that I have been anticipating here. Philly using their first team timeout, 15 minutes, 59 seconds remaining in the first period. Boston, with the shock right now of the tournament, they lead 43-15. And Al, if you are the coach of the Liberty Bells, what are you telling your team?
I would want to slow this game down. Boston is taking advantage of a very weak back line. You want to close that line up, start playing tighter to the jammer line, slow the game down. Philly has a lot more experience at this tournament play. Boston's nervous. They're playing a team that they thought they couldn't win. But if you look at the camera right now, they are all smiling. They're feeling really good about themselves. You have to turn that around.
Absolutely.
You have to make them tired, and you have to make them think about their play.
Absolutely. And when we return to action, the next jam will be brought to you by Bones Bearings, with Roller Bones and Bones Bearings, always a winning combination. Find them on the web at bonesbearings.com.
Philly playing down multiple blockers as they only have one blocker. Olivia Face out there and jamming Teflon Donna. Little Payne out there jamming for Boston. Got two standing in the box for Philly right now.
And they're going to need those two blockers right now because Little Payne charging right on in the outside area. And she is through and lead jammer for Boston.
You can't hold back Little Payne with one blocker. It doesn't matter who that blocker is. Boston now doing an excellent job of recycling back. Teflon Donna. Gets to the inside. Fixing the hit. You're doing an excellent job tonight. Dixie Chicks backing her up there. Little Payne gets 5 up on the board.
But right now she's going to have not a very difficult decision to make. She's going to have to decide if she wants to call it or risk Teflon Donna scoring points, because the Boston Massacre have the back wall. Teflon Donna not able to score any points. The jam gets called off on that pass. Boston with the lead, 48-15. 15 minutes remaining here in the first period. And when we return to action, the next jam is going to be brought to you by Jammer Up. You can play the very first strategy board game based on modern-day roller derby. Find them on the web at jammerup.com. And this is big news, Al. In the WFTDA Bracket Bonanza last week, the very first perfect bracket in the Bracket Bonanza right now, only 10 perfect brackets stand, and I think they may all be in danger right now.
This right now could turn everybody's brackets upside down. Could anybody do this?
Illegal procedure, major to antidote. She is being sent out.
Skated past the penalty box. She was not aware that she thought she was being called lead. She was not aware of the penalty, Sasha. Caused herself to have to go all the way around the track another time. Ginger Kid putting her in a real good position as Boston is up 3-2.
And right now it's a 2-2 here. Boston playing passive offense. Ginger Kid able to get through. That's 5 more points for Boston.
It's the crowd here is almost silent in a way of being in shock as you're watching the Boston Derby Dames manhandle or female handle the Philadelphia Liberty Bells.
And well, it's silent except over here in turn number 4 where the Boston fans are going ballistic after every single point is scored. That's another 5 points picked up. That's going to bring it to 58-15 in favor of the Boston Massacre. Once again, Boston playing passive offense right now. Full wall for the Philly Liberty Bells.
Maya's back up to the back trying to push her way through. I'm sorry, Ginger trying to push her way through. Ginger gets past one, swings around. They knock her out, recycle back to the back.
Olivia Face was able to recycle her back, but 2 blockers for Philly going into the box. That is Heavy Flow and Olivia Face, both of whom are going into the box.
Called for multiple pack blocking, multiple player blocking. Heading out to the box, setting Boston up for another amazing opportunity to score some points here. Any Dotes back in the play, but getting knocked around there from the inside by Dixie Chicks.
And the lap point was already assessed. That's 5 more points as the jam gets called off for Boston. Al, it is so loud in here, I don't think I can hear myself think.
Ginger Kid throws her arms up in the air like, what? It's just 5 points, what's up?
When we return to action, the next jam brought to you by the purveyors of the Derby Unusual. They're not crazy, they just like Derby. Find Derbyology on the web at derbyology.com. Once again, I can confirm, I know Barely Human and Dr. Psycho Cup personally. They aren't crazy, they just love Derby.
I don't know, I think they're kind of crazy, but who doesn't love Derby isn't crazy.
Well,
Mo Payne out there for Philly versus Maya for Boston. Maya is through, and once again, Boston dominating, owning the lead jammer title tonight.
Approach on the back of the pack. Boston Massacre again have the back wall. Maya Mangle, you able to get pass calls off the... Wait, no. 4 points. Okay. I was worried for a second there because the jam ref held up a fist and was like, wait a second. Then 4 fingers popped up. 72-15 is the score in favor of the Boston Massacre over the Philly Liberty Bells. 11.5 minutes remaining. If anybody had this in their bracket, I'm personally going to buy you an adult beverage of your choice.
Absolutely. Nobody had this in their bracket except for maybe somebody that walked in here wearing a Boston Derby Dame shirt.
Ginger Kid poodling right now, picking up the intentional 4th minor. She's going to the box. I bet we'll see her jamming next. There's a track cut major on Lil Payne. She went to the infield. Her momentum carried her back onto the track, and then she went back into the infield. But when she went back onto the track, she cut the foremost blocker. Therefore, it is Power Jam Liberty Bells who cannot stop the clock due to lead jammer status.
49 seconds left of this jam. Fixing the hit. You're doing an excellent job out there of holding back Teflon Donna. Resetting up the pack now. Boston's got a strong 4 wall up front. Ginger Kid and fixing to hit you.
5 points on the last scoring pass. Teflon Donna just completed another one. That's another 5 points, Al. 10 points thus far in this jam. Philly starting to strike a comeback.
Philly is definitely a good enough team. You cannot give them this opportunity to get these power jams and take advantage. Hold down that defense as they're doing right now. Boston's doing a great job going side to side, holding that wall, knocking her out, recycling her back. Beautiful job right there. Heavy Flow decides to go into that like a wrecking ball on an old building and just break that lead out.
Teflon Donna gets knocked to the outside by Dixie Kicks, has to re-enter behind once again as the jam reaches its natural conclusion. And if you thought this game, if you had any friend that told you this game would not be worth watching because it was number 2 versus number 7, you need to call them right now and get them on WFTDA.TV because this is amazing so far.
Absolutely amazing. People all over the world. Rumor has it we have some people from Iceland. I believe I'm not even going to try to say the name.
I'm going to try. If I'm wrong, they can correct me. Reykjavik, Iceland?
Reykjavik, Iceland. Any place called Reykjavik is definitely watching Roller Derby, and they are watching it, and they are live on Talk to WFTDA.
That's the hashtag if you want to talk to us. It is a Power Jam Antidote having to fight a four-wall by herself. 75-33 is the score. Antidote is lead jammers. We have 8.5 minutes remaining here in the first period.
Little Payne stuck to the back. She's being called out. Minor, was it a track cut they called her on? I believe it was a track cut they got her on, giving another power jam to Philly.
And the Boston fans here in the building not happy about that. That's a 5-point jam here. Philly starting to mount the comeback. Big hit right to the sternum there, Al.
Shark Week.
Good clean hit, right shoulder into the sternum.
Shark Week getting called out for that hit, though.
5 points once again completed here. The Boston fans not happy. Philly was down by over 50 points, now down by only 32. And they just completed another scoring pass, did Antidote for 5 more points, Al.
Right now, Philly is showing that it's just a few jams away. Anybody can take advantage and come right back into the game, and they are doing so. Bad person right now on Antidote, trying to hold it back. Antidote through for another 5 points. Boston is definitely picking up the penalties in this power jam also, as they are just recycling their blockers into the penalty box. Dottie Danger now released from the penalty box. And Little Payne is now back in the pack.
No points scored on that scoring pass as a no pass, no penalty. There was only one eligible blocker out on the track, and she passed that blocker due to no pass, no penalty. She is not eligible to score the points that were in the box, therefore a scoring pass without an actual score.
Bad person gets called for a low block, heading off to the penalty box. There's no room at the end.
And this is where Boston needs to make sure that they play clean from here on out, because this is the kind of damage that the Philly Liberty Bells can do. Now our next jam is going to be brought to you by Rydell Skates, the official skate of the WFTDA with unmatched quality and unmatched performance. And it will also be brought to you by the new Radar Villain Wheel. Find them on the web at rydellskates.com and radarwheels.com.
V-Diva versus Mayo Mangley. V-Diva in the black and blue out there for Philadelphia. Mayo Mangley out there in the white for Boston. If you're just joining us, you are seeing what can be an upset in the making, as Boston is leading Philadelphia at a score of 75-58.
And it's important to note, 34 points in the last two jams for the Philly Liberty Bells.
Philly is definitely mounting that comeback. Like you said, Boston cannot allow these big power jam situations. They got to slow themselves back down. Like I was talking about earlier with Philly, slow this down. Maybe it's time to call a timeout.
Absolutely.
Get back into your own head. Remember, you were just winning this game, and you still are winning this game. Don't throw it away. Don't start playing sloppy and nervous. Yep. Pull it back.
You have to take up the principle of Jamnesia there. It is a team timeout for Boston. Both teams have 2 timeouts remaining. Just like Philly used a timeout to get their heads back into the game, Boston has done the same.
Boston's attitude this weekend is amazing to me. They're usually a very excited team. They get really edgy and nervous, and that causes them some issues. They have been such a relaxed team this weekend. It's so impressive to see them playing at an entire new level since they lost a multiple array of their starters from last season.
And I do want to let you know, by the way, about Iron Doll Clothing. They are custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee, lifting and separating since 2009. Find them on the web at irondollclothing.com. I know you love the lift and separate, Al.
Oh, lift and separate. It's the only way I can do it at my age. I have to have somebody else lift it and separate it for me.
V-Diva is through. She's lead jammer for Philly. It happened so fast that it almost looked like a lightning bolt went through the building.
Philly now back in the game. 5-point grand slam up on the board for Philly. Seems like Philly has kind of gotten their skate legs together. V-Diva about to re-enter the pack. Takes the whole inside by herself.
That was a good sweep to the inside line. She realized she was about to run into a four wall, found the hole, and that is what you see with a skater like V-Diva, the awareness and the vision to see that, okay, maybe the wall isn't available for me, but the inside line is, and that door is only going to be open for a second, Al. You have to take it when it's open.
Roller derby is about two things: knowing where to go and then having the ability to get there. And that girl, V-Diva, has both of those abilities.
Absolutely.
Second to none.
75-67 is the score. 5.5 minutes remaining here in the first period. Jamming for Boston will be Lil Payne. And almost lead jammer for Boston's Lil Payne. Teflon Donna, the jammer for the Liberty Bells.
That's 247. I'm sorry, 527.
Devoid of mercy going into the penalty box. Teflon Donna not lead, but just got the lap point on a scoring pass as the initial pass was just completed for Lil Payne, who is the lead jammer. And Al, I don't know why she's not calling it.
Trying to play the clock. She's going against, taking a little bit of a chance here with a three-back wall. Now it's a 3-3 wall. Well, you know what she has? She's showing faith in her blockers to be able to hold that three wall back and taking that shot. And that's something that you don't see in Boston's past, and I'm glad to see that you see it in the future. We are at a 5-point game now. Score 77-72.
2 points were scored by Boston in that last jam. 4.5 minutes remaining here in the first period. As Al mentioned, 77-72. If you're just joining us because you got a frenzied phone call or text message from a friend of yours saying, hey, this is actually a good game, then you might want to know that I am Sasha Victim, and he is the Reverend Almighty. Philly in the black dresses and Boston in the white jerseys.
Ginger Kid has broken through on the inside line. Once again, she is your lead jammer. Fee Diva, though, is down low and chasing her down. Ginger Kid's a little nervous. She looks in over her shoulder when you see Fee Diva coming up, wisely calling off that jam. But like you said before, holding the players to no points is a win when you're playing somebody like Philly.
Absolutely. And you know what? You have to put yourself in the skates of Ginger Kid there when you have to think about what's going to happen. When you look back and you see V Diva, it's like you're being chased by a shark and you're in the water.
Exactly. There's no way around it. There's no land to swim to. Call it off. Yep. Start over.
Scoreless jam there as we will return to action. When we do return to action, next jam will be brought to you by Adam Wheels, a proud partner and the official wheel of the WFTDA. Find them on the web at adamwheels.com.
That's a little pain out there for Boston.
And that is going to be Antidote as lead jammer for the Liberty Bells.
Antidote so far 25 points scored for Philly in this game. Antidote does a beautiful spin on the outside, like a pirouette, like a young ballerina.
And right now, the jam referee signaling points. Both teams picking up 3 points in the last jam, 80-75.
Now he's holding up 2 for Boston.
Okay, so it's 79-75. Either way, my heart is beating through my chest as we have 2.5 minutes remaining here in the first period, Al.
By this point, everybody in roller derby, everybody out there thought that this would be about 125-40 game in favor of Philly. Well, yeah. We're at 79-75. That's why we play the game. It doesn't matter what it happens on paper.
Well, V Diva found that inside line. She is through and is lead. Boston's jammer is out as well. That's Maya Mangle Yu. Good jump there by V Diva. 4 points scored. No points for Boston. Al, my mathematics may not be the strongest in the world, but I think we have a tie game.
I believe we do. Folks at home, crack that good bottle of wine. Settle in for a tight evening. It's 79-79.
79-79, less than 2 minutes remaining. Of course, the discrepancy between the period clock and the jam clock. If the period clock ends while the jam is still ongoing, we go to the end of the jam clock.
As God intended it.
Play it through.
Play it through.
But it looks like we are going to have I don't know if this is a team timeout, an official timeout. Oh, no. It is a team timeout for Philadelphia with 1:37 remaining here. It could be possible they are using their official review as well. You do get one per period. And when points are at this level and this discrepancy, why not use your official review?
Absolutely. You get one per period. You're in the last jam of the night. Teflon Donner looks very serious out there. She's explaining her situation. We don't know what that is yet. I'm sure the referees will tell us if any changes are made.
And while we wait, I do want to let you know about Vanilla Derby and Vanilla Skates, always striving to exceed your expectations. And now available, you're a fashionista, Al, with upgraded Italian leather. You can find them on the web at vanillaskates.com.
I already got them.
Oh, you do?
Oh, yeah, they're fabulous. Extra wide, too. I like to say that the Vanilla Skates, they're wider, so they fit my small little round Shrek feet that I have. very comfortable, excellent. Back to the hard leather. I like it, the Italian leather. It doesn't break down like that old hard leather of some of the other skate manufacturers.
Absolutely. So, Al, let's talk about what we've seen so far. Boston came out swinging first 15 minutes. They took an almost 55-point lead on the Philly Liberty Bells. Philly has came back. They've tied it up. And both teams right now, if you are the we've already asked what you would do if you're the coach of Philly. If you're the coach of Boston, what are you doing right now?
Keep doing exactly what you're doing. Mm-hmm. Right now, you are playing at a level that you – on paper, weren't supposed to be able to play at. So don't change a thing. Keep smiling. Look at them. They're over there. They're dancing. They're smiling. This is not the Boston of the past. They had a lot of big names before, but they were always a little, I'd say, rigid. They were always maybe too tight, too focused into the game. They're turning around. They're joking with their fans. They are doing exactly what you need to. Nobody can tell them what to do because they are in a tie game right now with the number two team in the Eastern Region.
And once again, the last time a number two got beat by a number seven in the in any playoff tournament here in the WFTDA in the last few years, it was Minnesota advancing. A number seven seed advancing in the 2010 North Central Playoffs.
You know, Westerns had some, last weekend out in Westerns, we saw upsets. We saw things. We saw bracket breakers. We saw it today a little bit with London, Montreal. Some people said, oh, that was kind of an upset. Other people said, not really. If Boston wins this game, there's no one that can argue what an upset and what an upset in the favor of Boston, and I'm loving it right now.
And, you know, not just that tournament, but that was the tournament I believe I officially fell in love with Angel City, the Angel City Derby girls. They did absolutely phenomenal. That game against Rose City, if you have not gone back to the archives right here on WFTDA.tv, you have to go back and watch that game because it was an absolutely amazing game. The whole tournament was a really good tournament.
Let's talk about WFTDA.tv right now. If you're just listening to our voices and you're not watching this for $12 for the weekend, you high definition quality camera angles from every angle, you are seeing it like you were here. For less than what, 3 gallons of gasoline these days?
Yeah.
That's not even going to get you to the local boat down the street.
That's true. And you know what? If you're just joining us, no, you're not dreaming. The score is tied, 79-79. It looks like we are going to find out what the official review was all about here. And we're going to get back to action here. We'll let you know what the official review was about in here in just a moment. V-Diva is out of the pack first. Lead jammer for Philly.
Ginger, though, is right behind her. She's not going to give her any room to go as Ginger Kid chasing her down. V-Diva gets through, gets four up on the board, calls off the jam wisely.
All right, Philly, the official review, Philly challenged that there was a high block penalty. It was ruled that there was no high block penalty. So Philly arguing for penalties got declined in that situation. But you know what? It was worth it to use the official review, make sure the penalties are right, because it could mean the difference between a blocker being on the track and not being on the track.
Absolutely.
Al,
you can't throw away an official review in the half. If there's any question at all and you got a minute left, throw it out there, use it. If nothing else, it helps you talk to your players. While that one player is out there explaining the situation, you get to control the bench.
All right,
go back to Mo Payne.
And that's Lil Payne out there, a jam full of pain right here. Lil Payne jamming for Boston. Lil Payne is through for Boston. And they may go into halftime with the momentum here, Al.
Mo Payne right now looking at the back wall of Boston, doing an excellent job at squeezing her back. Lil Payne recycled to the back of the pack. She's looking at a two-wall in Philly.
It looks like an out-of-play situation was declared on Shark Week. She is going into the penalty box. Number 72, Gloria Grindham, was also going into the penalty box for Philly. As Lil Payne completes a 5-point scoring pass, Boston has taken the lead by 1 point.
Ladies and gentlemen, you were not expecting this. Nobody was. Lil Payne is shaking her head right now going, wasn't expecting this. Being chased by a family member, Mo Payne.
Period clock has lapsed. We're down to the jam clock here. Boston looking to add more points to the board. Not calling it off as she enters it. Points are accumulating to the fourth whistle. 4 points scored for Boston and 2 for Philly. Call your friends, call your neighbors, call anybody you know that is involved in roller derby. Boston at the half leads Philly 88-85. Al, I do not believe it.
If you are not watching this, you are insane. I love the Twitter tag. I love, talk to us all you want, but go on right now and order it. this is not going to be something you're going to want to watch the day after. But I'm going to watch it tomorrow and probably the next day and the next day on the archives.
As soon as the archives are available, this is the first bout I'm going to watch. Of course, if you purchase the streaming pass on WFTDA.TV, it is available to you immediately. So if you're out there listening and you're thinking, Sasha and Victim and Reverend Almighty are just making this up. Boston leading Philly at the half, 88-85. That can't be happening. It's real, and it's happening right here in Essex Junction, Vermont.
Robert E. Miller Expo Center is the place where dreams can come true.
Oh, my gosh.
And Boston has been dreaming about this for a long time. They did not expect that this year may put them in a position to go to the championships. Like I said, I spoke with Boston players who are calling this about a great learning experience.
Yep.
And they have figured out and they have learned one thing, and they have learned that they could win this game as they're going into the half.
And it's important to note, Boston has not been to championship since 2009. If they pull off the upset, they will advance to play the London Brawling in semifinal game number two. Of course, the first semifinal, Gotham Girls All-Stars against the Charm City All-Stars. The semifinal action starts at 2 p.m. right here on WFTDA.TV, but consolation bracket action starts at 10 a.m. You want to make sure, and this is all Eastern time, by the way, you want to make sure you're right here on WFTDA.TV. And Al, I think we need to take a breather because, once again, it's thumping right now. I don't think I can take any more. We will be right back in about 12 minutes with more action right here on WFTDA.TV.
Dang it, Mo. I can't stop. I keep running into everything except the kitchen sink.
Man, tell me about it. These toast knobs suck. I tried all of them. They feel like plastic and they keep popping off the stems.
I cannot stop. I wish somebody would help us. Help us. Help us.
Do you hear that?
I think we're needed.
Captain Ensign, can you help me?
Ensign skate boots?
Reckless wheels?
I wish somebody would help us. Help us.
It's okay, guys. I've got this one.
Wow! It's the Gumballer!
Try these Gumball Toe Stops. All natural rubber, no dyes, traction for any surface, and these will never pop off.
Jeez, thanks, mister!
This commercial is brought to you by Green Monster Roller Sports, Gumball Toe Stops, and Derby Skins.
They told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put 3 W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned, we're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.
You can never have too many roller derby t-shirts. Now you can get a new one every month from a league from around the world. Just join the Roller Derby Shirt Club. And while you're at it, sign up your derby wife.
Burlington, Vermont. If you're just joining us, I'm Sasha Victim.
I'm the Reverend Almighty.
And we have been blown away by this incredible, incredible game between the Boston Massacre and the Philly Liberty Bells. At the half, Boston, the number 7 seed, leading 88-85 over Philly. Now, if Boston holds on and pulls off the upset, it will be the first time a number 7 has defeated a number 2 in the WFTDA playoffs since the Thunder of the Tundra, the 2010 North Central playoffs where Minnesota beat Detroit. So Boston right now, I have to say, with the way that they're playing, it is their game to lose.
Boston came out. They are so relaxed, so comfortable. They are a team that is usually in the locker room the entire halftime. They were out about 5 minutes after the halftime, and out here talking with fans, moving around, dancing together, yeah. Skating together.
They're feeling
good.
They
are relaxed. And if anyone was asked me, what does Boston need to do to win this game? the exact same thing they did in the first half because they won the first half of this game.
Yeah. Now, Al, we have had some questions out there on Twitter. You can use the hashtag talk, the number 2, WFTDA, to talk to us and ask us questions about the status of Shania Stretcher. She is here and she is healthy. However, she is not playing in this game, and that is all we know. She is here, and that is literally all we know.
She was not on the roster tonight. We hope we see her in the games tomorrow. Speaking of being on the roster, though, we have V Diva coming up on the line for the Philadelphia Liberty Bells. If you're just joining us, they are wearing the black and blue against the Boston Derby Dames, a Ginger Kid wearing the white.
Yep. And, you know, this is one of those situations where Boston had the momentum going into the half, and you have to wonder, is the 15 minutes going to put a stop to the momentum, considering Boston was out here dancing and generally having a good time, and Philly came back out stone-faced. You have to think Boston is ready for this second half, Al.
Philly is a veteran team that has gone to nationals multiple times. They've been down in games before, not against Boston before, but they know how to come back, and they show it right away as V Diva gets lead jammer status.
And Ginger Kid chasing her down about a third of the track away. V Diva turning on the jets now, about a half track length away. Philly has the back wall. Boston skating fast in the front.
Boston's usually not a team that's skating fast. They're working fast. They have a very strong front line right there. In splatter. Ivana and
that is the jam
Rexia.
Called off.
Jam gets called off by Diva as she gets four up on the board.
And Philly has retaken the lead, 89-88. 29 and a half minutes remaining here in the first period, and when we return to action, our next jam will be brought to you by S1 Helmets, making the safest and best helmets for roller derby. Find them on the web at s-one.com.
Teflon Donner out there for the Philadelphia Liberty Bells versus Little Payne for the Boston Massacre.
3-on-3 in the pack. Both blockers for both teams are standing. And it was a fake out there on the rugby. Well, nope, I'm sorry. There wasn't a fake out on the rugby scrum start. The second whistle, it was kind of hard to hear.
Didn't blow out too much. Vixen to hit you, doing a great job right there of just holding back Teflon Donner enough, knocking her out of bounds there on the line a little bit.
Both jammers in the pack right now. Both packs are full. Lil Payne is out first for Boston, lead jammer status.
Shark Week just owning Teflon Donner there in the back and just escorted her right out of bounds. Little Payne reapproaching the pack right now as Teflon Donner is still at the back of the pack. Payne grabs to the inside, fixing a hitch and trying to open up a line. Takes one more shot against Teff before Teff is able to break it through. Payne on her scoring pass right now, looking at a three wall of Philly.
And Little Payne calls off the jam just as Castro delivered a shot right into the sternum with her shoulder. That is 4 points for Boston, who have retaken the lead, 92-89. And that shot from Castro was a legal shot because everything is legal until the fourth whistle blast.
V Diva coming right out there again against Maya Mengliu.
Pack advantages in favor of Boston, who are in the rugby scrum start. Philly has the front wall.
V Diva looking to take that outside line quick and hard. They get closes up really fast right there. Beautiful hit on Maya Mengliu. V Diva takes the middle, breaks through. She is not your lead jammer.
Not lead. Minor back block penalty is why she is not lead. Status is still eligible and has been awarded to Maya Mengliu, who calls it off.
Maya Mengliu definitely a little upset. It took them a while to call her lead jammer. She was waiting for it to happen so she could call the jam off. And V Diva was able to get inside the back and get some points right there.
Two points there for the Philly Liberty Bells. 92-91. 1 point separates these two teams as Boston has the lead. The fans over here in turn number 4 are significantly Boston fans. They were not happy with the call there on lead jammer status. And as we return to action here, it will be Ginger Kid for Boston going up against Antidote for Philly.
Antidote having a very successful first period, but so did Ginger Kid. Ginger Kid, one more to go. She gets recycled back, though. Beautiful hit right there by Teff. Nope, by 247. That's devoid of mercy.
Yeah. Who lives up to her name on most situations, Al.
She ends up taking it a little bit too far. She's heading off to the penalty box.
Well, you know, devoid of mercy, not exactly devoid of penalties. And it looks like she actually went past the point of no return line, so Devoid of Mercy has to make another full lap. You didn't see it on your screen as lead jammer status now going to Ginger Kid from Boston. Antidote only have one blocker to beat, and Vixen to hit you. She is out and on her scoring pass as well, Al. Jam gets called off. 1 point for Philly, zero for Boston. We are back to a tie game. Let us know what you think out there on the Twitterverse. End your tweets with the hashtag #talk2, WFTDA.
The Diva, Little Pain Boat out there on the jammer line again. They're going to be working them in the second half. What works for Philly so far is having V Diva just physically go through that middle of the pack. What's working for Boston is circling and holding her in that position. Little Pain's doing a great job at taking that outside line. V Diva, though, breaks the inside, gets through, and she is your lead jammer. Little Pain also through the pack.
So right now, it's all a matter of positioning and time. V Diva tried to get a hip whip off of Gloria Grindham, was not able to do so. 2 points for the Liberty Bells, zero for the Boston Massacre as Philly retakes the lead. When we return to action, our next jam brought to you by Blood and Thunder Magazine, the world's first and largest roller derby magazine. Find them on the web at bloodandthundermag.com.
Meyer Mangle, you out there on the line for Boston versus Teflon Donna. For Philly, if you're just joining us, it's 94-92 in favor of the Philly, who's wearing black and blue.
We've just been told that the Ithaca Gun Show, a new men's roller derby league in Ithaca, New York, is watching and wants to know how to hit like a girl after watching this bout. You can check out the archives on WFTDA.tv.
Study them hard.
Completely free and available to all as Teflon Donna right now is through. She is lead jammer for Philly. Philly with that 2 point lead, Al.
Teflon Donner about to re-enter the pack. Maya Mangle, you was able to break through. I don't think Tef realizes where she is.
She did not realize that at all.
Mangle, you got some points up on that board. Let's see what they give her for.
2 points for Philly, 4 points for Boston. We're back to a tie, 96-96. Oh my gosh.
Break out that second bottle of wine. We're going in overtime, folks.
I don't know if my heart can take this. And if you want to be a part of the action here on WFTDA.tv, consider sponsorship. You can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans by advertising here on WFTDA.tv. More information can be found at WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities.
Ginger Kid for Boston, V Diva for Philly. V Diva just physically pushing her way through that pack. She is now your lead jammer.
And I've noticed in the second half, V Diva is getting a lot of calls to go out there and be the jammer for Philadelphia. And that's a smart strategy because she has the power and the strength and the speed to get through a lot of these walls. It seems that they are having a hard time holding her as she completes a 5 point scoring pass on the Boston Massacre Ginger Kid. Now doing a little duel, she gets in front of V Diva.
Wow, V Diva not happy about that at all. Ginger Kid just a smile across her face. She took a good solid hit by V Diva trying to pull in a penalty off of her. Got right around her, causing V Diva to call off that jam.
Yeah, V Diva not wasting any time right now. Philly with the lead 101-96 as we have 22 and a half minutes remaining here in the second period. Al, the action has driven me insane.
It is going fast. Right now we're down one blocker by Boston. Against Philly has a full boat out there. Teflon Donna looking right on that inside line like nobody's watching. Let's see what happens.
And you can feel the breathlessness in the building as the anticipation for that first whistle to sound and then the second one to release the jammers. Teflon Donna is through and is lead jammer.
Little Payton heading off to the penalty box for major back block.
Oh my goodness, that is not what Boston needs right now. The last time there was a power jam, more than 20 points were scored on behalf of Philly. 4 points scored on that pass right there. Boston's jammer is sitting, so the time has started on her penalty.
It was basically two power jams that put Philadelphia right back into this. Boston's yet to have the opportunity to score that big power jam. Teflon Donna now with a grand slam, 5 points up on the board, is fixing to hit you, heading off to the penalty box for hitting out of play.
Right now, Boston has to keep it as clean as they possibly can, and I know it's difficult when you have a jammer the caliber of Teflon Don out there. They are running the risk of out-of-play major situations. 5-point score there on that pass. And Philly starting to widen that gap a little bit.
19-point lead right now for Philly, 115-96. As Tef is fully taking advantage of this power jam. Another 5 points and another penalty out of play, for Boston.
Out of play major on Shank, and that has been the story of this jam here. 24 points in this jam have been in that last jam. Here you see on the replay, Teflon Donna having to go past two blockers, and they are at risk for the out of play majors. And I have to say, I know my good buddy Dr. Shonuff is out there for DC. He's watching. He says this bout is worth more than the $12 that he has paid to be a part of WFTDA.TV action.
You know, you pay $15, $20 to see one bout at your local roller derby. You go in, the chances of getting this level of play, probably not going to happen. And you get to see this and so many more bouts this weekend. Back to the bout at hand right now.
Looks like one more point was assessed to Philly, so they had a 25-point power jam as it is. I believe that's number 87, Goldie, as the lead jammer for Philly.
Philly has a full boat right there now. All four blockers out on the pack, out on the track. Little Payne having a very hard time, falls down. Meanwhile, Goldie takes on the inside and gets 5 points up on the board.
And this is the break that Philly needed. They needed that power jam more than they've needed any power jam in recent history, Al.
Boston has played jam for jam against Philly through this entire game. The only losing factor in this is the power jams. They need to, I would take a timeout right now. I would kind of reset.
I was actually wondering about if that would be a good strategy as well. 130-96 is the score. Philly does have the lead, 19 minutes remaining. When we return to action, our next jam will be brought to you by Derby for All. Experienced Derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. Find them on the web at derby4all.com.
Ginger Kid coming up on the line versus V-Diva. These two have been going at each other all night long. V-Diva takes that inside line, outside line, untouched. She is your lead jammer. That girl loves to be called lead jammer. She just puts a smile on her face.
Yeah.
When V-Diva smiles, I smile.
Especially when she smiles at you, right?
When she smiles at me, I smile a lot
more.
Well,
she just smiled at the Boston fans. A little bit of incendiary smiling going on here.
She's going to give them the pinch right now. Watch her. She's going to go by. No, she didn't do it this time. V-Diva threw untouched. Oh, definitely getting a little cocky out there.
You know, I hate to say this, you really can't afford to be cocky right now. Boston put up 55 unanswered points earlier in the day, Al. They may have the lead right now, but Boston, who is taking a timeout right now, Boston has shown in this game they can mount that kind of a comeback. So while V-Diva is a fan of showing off, I don't know if this is the right time to do it. With 18 minutes remaining in the game, there is still plenty of Derby to be played.
Or is she getting inside the head of the Boston Derby Dames, knowing that they've been playing very calm. They've been playing with smiles on their face.
Absolutely.
Maybe she's trying to, hey, let's add a little something to the mix. Maybe knock the smile off the face a little bit. Be a little cocky, and maybe that'll make them play a little sloppier.
Yep. Absolutely. Boston has one team timeout remaining. 18 minutes and 8 seconds left on the clock. 139-96, 43 points separating these two teams. As our next jam, when we return to action, will be brought to you by Sin City Skates, your WFTDA skate techs who help keep you on the track.
It's nothing like watching the Liberty Bellheads on the sidelines. Those girls are just weird. And I mean that in a good way.
That's part of the fun of the Philly of the Philly Roller Girls.
Any girl that would wear a bell on her head, have a unitard, could easily call herself my wife.
Okay.
Bring her home. Guess what I brought home, Dad?
Oh, boy.
A unitard-wearing bell. Good for you, son. Good for you.
I don't know how to follow that, so I'll just tell you that jamming out on the line right now, number 27 is Shank for Boston, going up against number 85, Teflon Donna for Philly.
Teflon Donna, like I said, one of the most well-rounded players in roller derby. Stuck behind Boston's new one of the newest players in all.
Teflon
breaks through, though. She is your lead jammer.
Yeah, Teflon Donna is lead. She was able to survive the hit from anorexia. She got knocked to the ground, but it was dangerously close to out of play, so she had to let her go. Teflon Donovan approaching the pack on the scoring pass. Was able to get through on one skate to call off the jam. 4 points for Philly.
Wisely, beautiful hit there by Anorexia Rana, though, forcing her to call that jam off, and she almost made it through. I can tell you, Anorexia, Vixen to hit you, the Dixie Kicks, these are names that we're not talking about through this whole bout, but these are the girls that are controlling that inside pack for Boston, allowing Boston to score points and stay in this game.
All right, now it is 143-96, 17 minutes remaining here in the game at this point. Once again, this game has driven me crazy. It is V Diva right now jamming for Philly, and almost through. She is through for Philly.
V Diva is definitely a welcome change to Philly. I mean, that girl is just working hard tonight, opening up the doors. 5 points scored right there. They have been just working horse her since they got her from Dutchland.
Yeah, the speed and the agility that she has, she can get through, and then, you know, 10 seconds later, she's through the pack again.
Jumps the axis like it's nothing.
Apex jumps for V Diva, picking up another 5 points. It looks like Lil Payne not sure where she needed to re-enter there, and that's going to give V Diva enough time to score 5 more points there.
They said she may be cocky, but it's because she's good.
Yeah, well, you know, it isn't bragging if you can back it up, Al.
And she's backing it up right now.
Absolutely.
She goes right into that pack, takes out two, gets two more on the board. Fidiva now.
And that is 64 unanswered points in the last several jams, Al. 160-96, as we have 15 minutes and 45 seconds remaining here in the game. When we return to action, our next jam brought to you by SISU Mouthguards. Safe, smart, comfy, talk, breathe, drink only SISU Mouthguard. Find them on the web, SISUguard.com.
Someday they'll make a mouthguard for announcers. That will be strange, but we'll do it.
I would sound more distorted than I usually sound.
Yeah, God knows what I'll sound like.
So if you're just joining us here, the score was tied 96 all just a few jams ago, and then Philly broke the door wide open. 64 unanswered points thus far. Boston was on the verge of the upset, still not out of this game in the slightest, as we have 15 minutes, 42 seconds. And it's important to note, Boston had a 55-point lead with about 15 minutes to go in the first period when Philly started to mount that comeback, Al.
Exactly. We had said it earlier. You can't give Philly an opportunity to get those power jams. That changes the momentum. We saw it happen at about the middle of the first half. They got two power jams in a row that put them back into the game. Boston was able to go jam for jam with them going into the half. Actually went in with a three-point lead. Came out and they were playing them again. We had score change back and forth, but it was once again the power jam that just reabsorbed the energy out of Boston into Philly, and now V Diva is on fire. She's scoring points at will and taunting the Boston fans while she's doing it.
Yeah, right now she has 60 points out there. When she has been a jammer, she is the leading scorer for Philly. Lil Payne is the leading scorer for Boston with 52 points. No skaters really look to be in severe penalty trouble, with the exception of maybe Damaged Doll for Philly with 4 trips to the box. Nobody on Boston has more than 3. There are 3 skaters for Boston who have 3 trips to the box. That's Anorexia, Shark Week, and Lil Payne, all who have 3 trips to the box. And Al, it's important to note, this is just day number 1 of the Sugar Bush Showdown. Consolation Bracket does start tomorrow at 10 a.m. Eastern, right here in the Champlain Valley Exposition. You can find the action on WFTDA.tv. The first game will be Montreal versus Dutchland. Second game, D.C. versus Steel City.
Now, you see how that changes on the sidelines. You look over at Boston right now, they're pretty serious. They still got little smiles, they're pretty serious. You look over to Philly, oh, now I just say that, they're smiling and giggling away. They're having a good time. These girls did not think that they were going to be in this game against Philly, and man, have they just made the people of Boston and the fans of Boston very proud.
Yeah, Al, as you said, Boston came into this treating it like a learning experience, and thus far they've learned that they can hang with the Philly Liberty Bells.
Absolutely.
Now, of course, it's important to note we already mentioned the consolation bracket. The semifinals start at 2 p.m. It will be the Gotham Girls All-Stars, the number one seed, going up against the number four seed, Charm City. And then the winner of this game, whoever it may be at this point, because once again, it's still a toss-up.
Absolutely, we'll 15 minutes left.
We'll go on to take the number six seed, London Brawling. London was able to defeat Montreal earlier today, so that busted probably a few brackets out there.
Absolutely, and imagine either team, either one of these teams, London has an opportunity. A team that a year ago, when they were ranked into the region, people said, why are you ranking a team that doesn't even play against our teams in? And then they came in and they showed well. Now they beat Montreal. London has an opportunity to make it to championships.
Yep. And you know what? And I have to say, we weren't believers either. Both you and I were not sure in 2011 if London belonged because they hadn't won a game. They have more than proven us wrong. But also, you know, I do want to mention that after that game is over, the consolation bracket continues at 6 and 8 on Saturday. Carolina will be in the 6 o'clock game. They will take on the winners of D.C. versus Steel City. And then the loser of this game, whether it's Boston or Philly, will await Dutchland or Montreal. That will be at 8 o'clock. And the action continues right here on WFTDA all weekend as we head into the final day on Sunday. All the placement bouts will take place. We'll find out who will join Ole, Denver, Bay Area, Naptown, Minnesota, and Windy City going into championships. That is going to be November 2nd through the 4th. Grits and Glory taking place at the Georgia World Congress Center in Atlanta, Georgia. If you cannot be there live, you can buy a streaming pass for the action for $20. Or if you've already bought all five tournaments, you don't have to worry. You don't have to pay. You're already good.
The person that paid that $50 up front early on, the $50 that they've been watching the best roller derby that they have. Yep. It looks like Philly is challenging that Little Pain Cut the Track. Got a track cut major. And it was ruled a minor cut.
Yeah, because when I noticed that Lil Payne wasn't sure where she should re-enter, she was actually on the track and went back in. She cut one blocker, but it was not the foremost blocker. Therefore, it was a minor track cut on Lil Payne. We are back to action right now. V-Diva jamming for Philly. I believe that is Ginger Kid out there for Boston. It is, in fact, Ginger Kid.
Fixing the hitch, you're doing an excellent job right there, holding back V-Diva. Shark Week, Dixie Kicks. Meanwhile, Ginger Kid breaks through. She is your lead jammer.
And you know, you have to wonder if Philly taking that official review helped motivate the Boston Massacre, because right now Boston has come out swinging once again. They have six. Oh my God, La Pirouette right there as she takes a fall and calls off the jam. 3 points for the Boston Massacre as they have started to answer back on Philly's streak.
Little way to go to catch up, but they are willing to do it. We are looking at 160 to 99 in favor of the Philly Liberty Bells. If you just joined us, I don't know where you've been all night. You're crazy.
You probably got frantic text messages as we have less than 15 minutes remaining here in the game. This next jam, by the way, brought to you by Fast Girl Skates, the world's first brick and full-service brick and mortar roller derby store, bringing their extensive in-store experience to you online at fastgirlskates.com.
Teflon Donner out there for Philly versus Maya Mangle, you out there for the Boston Derby Dames. Teflon Donna breaks on the inside. She is your lead jammer. Maya Mangle, you looking at that backside of 247 herself.
That's devoid of mercy. And Mangle has made it through. She is approaching. Teflon Donna calls off the jam. 2 points for Philly and 2 points for Boston. That jam was a wash. It will be, I believe, 162 to 101, less than 14 minutes remaining in the game, Al.
Still on the edge of my seat. This is a great game. Don't let the 61 points fool you. This game has gone toe-to-toe, except for a couple power jams. Every moment in this game has been exciting. I'm not counting Boston out yet.
Absolutely not. And this next jam brought to you by Bont Skates, the only quad boot manufacturer with carbon and fiberglass counters. Find them on the web at bont.com.
That's Mo Payne out there versus Ginger Kid. Mo Payne for Philly, Ginger Kid for the Boston Derby Dames. Ginger Kid fighting her way through, trying to get through. One more to go.
And she
working
almost,
that inside line.
She almost got nudged into lead jammer status by Olivia Face before Olivia Face repositioned herself.
She did get through. She is your lead jammer.
But she had to fight for it. Olivia Face did not make that easy for her in the slightest.
Shark Week and Anorexia did their best they could to hold back Mo Payne. allowing Ginger Kid to get in there.
Ginger Kid calls off the jam as she was brought down. 3 points for the Boston Massacre and 3 points for the Philly Liberty Bells. Two consecutive jams where the points were assessed, and the Boston coach is out in the center. He's out there right now. He's not happy with the slow call-offs, and he's talking with Matt S. Faction as he came back on the inside. And, you know, it looks like we're going to have an official timeout. And I can't fault the Boston coach for this. Your team is on the verge of potentially pulling off an upset. They had the lead earlier. Fight for your points. Fight for your points.
Absolutely. The thing is, though, she was calling off the jam from her back as she went to the outside.
Yeah.
I got to be on the ref side here. They're looking through an entire pack of players. They're not going to see that jam. What she should have done is thrown her body up as she was calling the jam off so they would see her rise.
And that's one of the call-off hints that a lot of leagues are starting to use. Don't just go hips. Go head, hips. So that way they can see you're actively saying, I am calling off this jam.
It's very difficult to determine what you're doing when you're laying down looking up from the floor. Still a great play by Boston calling off that jam.
And we do want to note this is an official timeout right now. Clock frozen at 12 minutes and 37 seconds. Back to your point, Al. I'm sorry.
No point to be made.
It just completely escaped our brains here. But while we have the moment here, I do want to let you know about Union Vacations. And if you are this year's Bracket Bonanza winner, you will win a trip for two to the WFTDA Championship Tournament in 2013. Venue to be determined. But, man, there's already been a perfect bracket, and there's only, 10 perfect brackets remaining. So you're going to need to be perfect if you can pull off to win the Bracket Bonanza.
I'm telling you right now.
We've just been informed that someone out there has said that he is 6'3", 322 pounds, and he's a pretty strong dude. And there is no doubt in his mind that V-Diva could kick his butt.
And there's no doubt in my mind either, Justin. There's no doubt in my mind.
And you can talk to us out there on the Twitters by sending us a tweet with the hashtag #talk2 WFTDA. Once again, 165-104, official timeout still in process.
If you're here, it's 165 Philly, 104 Boston. And if you're listening to us on the feed, remember that score does not really dictate what this game has been. And at any moment, I expect Boston to have a big blow. They need to get that one power jam, and I think it's going to come for them.
Yep, and as soon as we find out what the issue with the official timeout was, we will let you know as soon as possible. We're about to return to action here. Once again, we will give you the information on that official timeout as soon as we have it. Teflon Donna jamming against Maya Mangalyu.
Teflon Donna gets pushed to the inside. Maya Mangalyu trying to fight the outside line right there. She has one more to go. Maya Mangalyu is just muscle. That girl just pushes her way through everything. She is not your lead jammer, though. Tef gets lead jammer call.
Minor forearm penalty is why Maya Mangalyu was not lead jammer. Teflon Donna called off the jam immediately upon exiting the pack.
Actually surprised that Teflon Donna called that jam off so quickly. You might have wanted to chase her in a little bit. Yep. Let the clock trip just a second. Looks like Boston challenged a minor upheld. No major since not.
It was the little pain cut penalty that we were talking about. Boston did use an official review to challenge that. The minor cut for Lil Payne has been upheld. It was not a major because, as we mentioned, it was not the foremost blocker that she cut.
So it had nothing to do with the point. He wasn't out there arguing the points.
You got to think he probably said something about that while he was out there.
By the way,
I want to challenge this minor penalty, but also, hey, let's get with the call-offs here. As it is going to be Ginger Kid jamming against V-Diva. V-Diva is out and through, lead jammer for Philly.
V-Diva's strong stride as she is almost ready to re-enter the pack. Ginger just breaks it through.
Major track cut on Ginger Kid. She is going to go into the penalty box.
Boston is out there with only one blocker out on the track. No jammer. This is exactly what Philly needs to run away with this game.
It's absolutely the wrong jammer to have that kind of situation against, because that is V-Diva out there, leading scorer for Philly, who currently has 70 points, and it's going to be more right now. That's going to be the completion of the scoring pass. That'll bring the score up to 180 to 104 in favor of the Liberty Bells as we have less than 11 minutes remaining here in the game. V-Diva with a big grin on her face. It's almost like, you know, she's heading to a buffet and she's hungry as she devours the pack. Five more points for the V-Diva. And Al, this is what right now has sort of put sort of a chop block on Boston is the incredible skills of V-Diva here.
the Divas Power Jams, the fourth minor.
Major for skating out of bounds. Oh, sorry, a minor, fourth minor for skating out of bounds. That's going to spring Ginger Kid Power Jam back to Boston.
Not before the damage was done, though. We only have 25 seconds left in this jam. Feet even scored 20 points so far in that jam.
And if I'm not mistaken, Ginger Kid is also still on her initial pass as well. She was assessed a minor back block penalty. She needs to be careful out there as she plummets to the ground. The question is, Al, will the power jam carry over?
The power jam does have time to carry over to the next jam. But once again, it's two first and oh no, heading up for a major track cut.
Major track cut on Ginger Kid. Well, I'm sorry, no, minor, fourth minor.
Fourth minor track cut.
Fourth minor track cut. So V Diva was able to put up 4 points before she went to the penalty box. We're going to start with both jammers in the box.
Senior Macho Solo out in the center of the ring. Looks like with timeout being called for Boston.
Boston using their last timeout.
Let me kind do this.
yeah, you can do that, but I have to wonder, a questionable choice here, Boston using their last timeout.
I think at this point, I actually don't think it's questionable. It's an 85-point lead.
Yep.
If there's any better time to do the call out, they just lost the jammer in a power jam to the box. If he could ever get that reversed, that's an opportunity.
That's true.
If they don't get that reversed, the opportunity is slipped away to win this game.
That's the thing, is they're out. The Boston coach is out there right now with the Philly coach. My guess is hoping to get that minor track cut reversed. But if he's not able to do it, I mean, he's going to lose that timeout, and if Boston mounts the comeback, they will not be able to stop the clock in the final 10 minutes. Once again, clock frozen, 9 minutes, 32 seconds. Philly with the lead, 189-104. Al.
Justin's got that sinister little smirk. I love it. He's just out there. He's holding back. He didn't get it to work.
Didn't get it to work.
Good try. He had to throw it out there. Make it work. There's not much more they can do with it.
Sometimes in life, you have to roll the dice and see what happens. When we return to action, the next jam will be brought to you by 2-in-1 Skate Shop. You can take 10% off of your entire order at 2in1skateshop.com when you use the coupon code Bonanza during checkout. 2-in-1 Skate Shop, shock the competition. And by the way, shop is spelled the old-time way, S-H-O-P-P-E.
Or we call it Shoppe, wherever.
Shoppe, yes.
Oh, Vixen, the Hitcher, has got that sad look on her face. Oh, just want to run over there and give her a hug if I didn't think she wouldn't punch me in the face.
Yep. So right now is now an official timeout as looks like there's some discussion of the penalty box situation right now. Trying to figure out how much time is remaining and what to do from there. V Diva was in the box as the jam ended, so it is my understanding she will stay in the box until the next jam starts, and then she will be released.
Should be released immediately after that, where there's no jammer on the line on the first whistle.
Yep. So once again, clock frozen in time right now as the jam starts. 189-104, V Diva. Now standing in the penalty box, waiting to be cleared by the penalty timer. She has to serve 10 seconds, I believe it was the situation. As V Diva now sort of approaching the wall, she didn't want to run a risk of a back block penalty there. She's got Vixen to Hitch to beat. Saloma Splatter tried to go forth, but the bridge. V Diva was out. She is lead jammer.
Great job by lead jammer being able to by V Diva being able to control herself out there as the jammer, holding her arms down straight, just being very relaxed, forcing a little pressure on the back of the wall, but like you said, not putting up a situation where she could be called for the back block there.
Yeah, absolutely. She's got to be extremely careful now because once again, a jammer switch out springs the Boston jammer, and this is the point where you want to try and put that dagger into the heart of Boston.
Well, the dagger has been set, and it's another 5 points. 199 Philly to 104 Boston as V Diva calls that jam off.
Jam does get called, and ever since that 96-96 jam, Philly has managed to put up 103 points to Boston's 8. The score right now, 199-104. 95-point lead for Philly as we have 8 minutes remaining here in the game, Al.
Trying to mess up my mind with math, aren't you? Mayo Mangle, you out there against Annie Doat. Annie Doat is one of the newer players to Philly's All-Star, and I'm very impressed with her play tonight. Yep. Doing an excellent job, very small, able to make herself compact, and as you can see, goes right for the middle, doesn't look for the hole. She goes to make the hole. Very physical player, and she pushes through. She is your lead jammer, antidote.
Antidote through once again, and for each lead jammer status that Philly is getting, they have to be feeling more comfortable that they're going to meet London in the semifinal. Game still nowhere close to over, though.
Antidote takes a big dive, big jump into the center. Gets through another 4 points up on the board.
And that's going to be almost 100-point lead here for Philly, 203-104, with 7 minutes remaining here in the game when we return to action. Our next jam will be brought to you by Green Monster Roller Sports, the makers of Antic, Gumball Toe Stops, Heartless Wheels, Reckless Wheels, and Moto Bearings. They don't just give you great derby products, they give you confidence. Find them on the web at grnmnstr.com. Once again, since I slipped, I'm dyslexic, I can't help it. grnmnstr.com.
Back to the action at hand. That's Teflon Dunner out there for Philly. That's Little Payne out there for the Boston Derby Dames. Little Payne breaks through. She is your lead jammer. Teflon Dunner, though, breathing right down her neck as they exit the pack almost together.
And it looks like Little Payne is going to trust her blockers to... Oh, no, she's going to call off the jam instead. So no points scored on either side on that jam.
It's a situation where Boston has played an excellent bout. They played the number two seed in the East. They did everything they could. I'd love to see a situation like that where Little Payne goes, you know what, let's just go it and trust in her defense and just go through. Not criticizing the way they're playing at all, because they've played an excellent, excellent game.
Yeah, and you know, that does show the faith that Little Payne has in her blockers as well. And sometimes, you know, they may not pull out the win here, but it also shows confidence. And Boston, if they don't win here, can still play for fifth. So that confidence in your own blockers is very, very important.
Ginger Kid coming out on the line for the Boston Derby Dames versus V Diva.
Delayed start to the jam there as Boston had to force a no-pack situation. V Diva is through. She is lead jammer for the Philly Liberty Bells.
V Diva just goes so low. It's hard to believe how tall she is when she's out there skating.
Oh, yeah.
She shrinks down inside the pack, comes out. Then she stands up on the other side, and you're like, oh. 4 points up on the board for VD.
And you know, that says a lot about her core strength and her conditioning, that she's able to get as low as she is, because I'm about 6'2". She is right about the same height as me. So she's able to get real low, then pop right back up to get the speed she needs on the turns and straightaways. It takes core conditioning, as I'm sure you know, Al.
Yeah, it took me a half an hour to get up out of this chair earlier. I mean, I'm not going to move like that, girl. She is amazing.
When we return to action here, there will be less than 5 minutes remaining on the period clock. Philly has a 103-point lead. Antidote, the jammer for the Liberty Bells. But it's going to be the Boston jammer, Maya Mangalyu, who is lead, Al.
Maya Mangalyu did break through the pack, but Antidote is breathing right down her neck. With 4 minutes left, I say, don't even think about calling off the jam. Just run through the pack. Let's play the game.
Yeah, trust your blocker. See what you can do.
No points scored for either jammer.
Oh, no. There was a bit of hesitation there. 1 point was scored as Philly now has officially doubled up on the Boston score, 208-104. 4 minutes remaining here in the game, Al.
Interesting call there by the referee. He had put up no points scored. Antidote was definitely rushing him on the 1 point. He changed his point score.
And this next jam will be brought to you by Wicked Skatewear. Wicked Skatewear hearts their sponsored leagues, such as Denver, Bay Area, Arizona, and Angel City, which I would think B-Train would sponsor her own team. Find them on the web at wickedskatewear.com.
Lil Payne out there skating for Boston. Teflon Donna out there for Philly.
Once again, we are now below 4 minutes remaining here in the game. As Lil Payne is through, she's not lead due to a minor track cut. Teflon Donna is lead.
Teflon Donna playing very wisely. She knows the clock's ticking down. No points can be scored until you get to her players in the pack. She's even letting her get into the pack before she calls off the jam.
A wise veteran maneuver there by Teflon Donna, knowing that she could take about 15 seconds off of the clock. Go ahead, call off the jam after letting the approach happen. So once again, 3 minutes remaining here in the game. Philly has doubled up on the score of Boston, 208-104. What a game this has been, Al. A complete roller coaster.
Up and down, the heartbreak for Boston. they played it toe-to-toe against the number two team through this entire bout, minus a few power jams.
Yeah, and I would argue it's not really so much heartbreak as it is a confidence booster for them as well, knowing that they can play as well as they did. If they can play that level of derby, I have the feeling they're going to be a tough team to beat in the race for fifth place in the consolation bracket.
Absolutely, and this was a rebuilding year for Boston. This team lost so many starters at the beginning of the year. They weren't expected to even be at this level of play.
Yep.
What a great program they have that can get them there. Ginger takes a step to the inside. Does she get any points
up
on the board?
2 points for Philly, 2 points for Boston. So 210-106 there. Ginger Kidd was entering the pack. V Diva noticed and called off the jam, but not before Boston was able to put 2 points on the board. And Al, when the next jam starts, we will have a discrepancy between the period clock and the jam clock. And of course, we, you know, we will go until that jam clock ends.
Jam clock is now in charge, or the lead jammer if one is called.
Yep, there's about 8 seconds of discrepancy here.
You got to think, if Philadelphia gets this, they're just going to let it run out.
Yeah, they have no real incentive to call off the jam. They have a 104-point lead. They might as well go ahead and bleed the time off the clock, especially due to a backblock major penalty here on Maya Mangalyu. Once again, no incentive for Philly to call off the jam, as their coach is saying, keep it moving.
Mo Payne almost called the jam off. She had her hands up in the air. Coach for Philly reaches in, says, nope, just skate it. I'm not even really sure that she's aware that it's a power jam yet.
Even then, you know, if her coach is telling her to continue going, why not keep going? 5 point scoring pass completed there by Mo Payne. The bench chanting along with her name to encourage her out on the track. Fighting a four wall on her own. Bridging going on there. Dixie Kicks bridging for Boston is finally Mo Payne able to get through 5 points. For the Liberty Bells.
Still 53 seconds left to the period clock. A little over 1 minute left to the jam clock. Mo Payne's got a lot of skating left to do. I'm actually surprised. This is how much of an athlete she is. She's not just out there slowly skating around absorbing the clock. She's like, I want to get back and
hit
a girl.
Yeah,
I want some more points up on the board.
Well, right now, 220-106, as we have less than 30 minutes remaining in the game. Less than 30 seconds in the game. 40 seconds on the jam clock as Maya Mangalyu has returned to action. Once again, Philly with no real incentive to call off the jam here.
Payne is now back out on the pack.
Initial pass completed by Maya Mangalyu.
Mangalyu going to be going in for a scoring pass. Nothing's going to make Mo Payne stop this jam before that 4 seconds is over.
Nothing's going to stop her now, Al, except for maybe zero on the penalty, on the timer. That's the game. Unofficial score, 225 Philadelphia, 106 Boston. And if Boston, if I see a single skater on, I'm sorry, we do have an official score in now, 229-110. And Al, personally, if I see a single skater from Boston with their heads hang low, they have absolutely nothing to be ashamed of. Philly is a very tough team, and they hung in there with one of the sport's best.
Exactly. The number seven team just went toe-to-toe with the number two, with the Rocky Balboas of women's roller derby. Went toe-to-toe with them. There was about five or six jams in this entire game that really put it into Philly's pocket. Every other jam, how many jams did we see? 2-2, 3-3,
absolutely.
5-5.
Absolutely.
How many lead changes did we play? I mean, if you're out there playing that roller derby drinking game, don't drive anywhere because there were so many lead changes.
Yep.
I'm sure you're a little inebriated
now. And top scorer for the Philly Liberty Bells was V Diva with 100 points, solid. And most of those points were scored in the second half. It seems once Philly realized that was the winning combination, they kept jamming V Diva. Now, it's important to note, this sets our semifinal brackets. At 2 p.m., you will see the Gotham Girls All-Stars going up against the Charm City All-Stars. It's New York versus Baltimore. And then from there, London will go up against Philly in the semifinals. One win from either of those teams, they've already punched their ticket to championships, and then they will be fighting for the first round bye. Of course, the consolation bracket starting right here on WFTDA.TV at 10 a.m.
Walking into this weekend, if somebody told me that Philadelphia and London were going to be playing for anybody, I mean, we're going to be playing against each other, I would have said it's not going to happen. Two, if they said that London had an opportunity to beat Philly and play to go to nationals, I'd say it's not going to happen. Guess what? I was wrong.
Yeah.
London played a very dominating game today against Montreal. Boston almost upset the Philadelphia Liberty Bells.
And they did a fantastic job. And once again, a victory to kind of hang your hat on. They have nothing to be ashamed of. This was a great game for the Boston Massacre and a confidence builder for them as well, especially since they are in a rebuilding year as a program at the Boston Derby Dames.
Absolutely. I know that we have Hyman Heaven coming up in just a few moments with an interview with, as I said, my favorite redhead, Teflon Donna, and what a game they had.
And signing off here for WFTDA.TV, this is Sasha and Victim.
I am the Reverend Al Mighty. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
Bright and early, 10 a.m.
Teflon Donna, don't stop believing playing in the background. I kind of think Philly fans never stopped believing, but take us back to the first half of this game.
Well, I think traditionally we get to play Boston in April. They usually invite us up to their venue at the Shriners, and it's a game that we look forward to. Unfortunately, they didn't invite us this year. They've got a lot of new skaters. We still didn't underestimate them whatsoever at all. We did a lot of research from the footage that we could find and tried to come into this game as prepared as we could. But obviously, the best test of how you're going to do against an opponent is getting the opportunity to actually play against them before tournament season, and we didn't have that opportunity.
And you did have a chance to see them at the East Coast Derby Extravaganza, where they actually beat Arizona, I think, and came pretty close to beating Charm.
Yeah, and that's some of the footage that we used to do our research.
So that's the first half of the game.
Yes.
Now, take us into the locker room. What was the conversation like there?
The conversation there was sort of, you know, clear your heads about what happened in the first period. Let's learn from our experiences. We're not really playing the way that we intended to play this game, so let's refocus. Let's go out there in the second half and play our game.
So in the second half, V-Diva had a lot of luck, a lot of extraordinary opportunities as a jammer. She opened the door a little bit. You got in there. The patient offense was working really well for you guys against Boston for a while. Talk about that.
Well, their walls were really strong, and if we could send in just a little bit of help that could get their walls moving forward just a little bit, it was enough that our jammers could power through and use that forward momentum. It was really when they didn't have any forward momentum that they were using some really brutal hits to just knock us around, something that we weren't quite used to. So.
And of course, in the first half, penalties,
penalties
a big factor.
Penalties were a huge factor in the first half. There's something that we focus on all season long. We try to play a clean game. It's really clear to us when we go back and look at footage that we suffer significantly, like every other team, when you don't have your players out on the track. So keeping our players out on the track is important.
So tomorrow you move on to play London. What do you expect London to bring? And is there now a sense among the Liberty Bells not to take anything for granted?
Well, I don't think we were taking anything for granted to begin with. It's very clear that despite the fact that London doesn't get the same opportunities as the rest of the teams in North America, that they're good students of roller derby here in, you know, in North America. And they're strategic, they're both physical, and I think we're going to look for a very physical and mental game tomorrow, something that we're going to just have to be on top of our game if we want to come out ahead.
All right, well, Teflon Donna of the Liberty Bells, that was the final bout of the evening, Philly 229 over Boston 110. We are live from Sugarbush Showdown. You're going to want to tune in to WFTDA.TV tomorrow, starting at 10 a.m. We are going to kick this day off right. Saturday, the Bells take on London. We will see you there.
Dang it, Mo. I can't stop. I keep running into everything except the kitchen sink.
Man, tell me about it. These toe stops suck. I tried all of them. They feel like plastic and they keep popping off the stems.
I cannot stop. I wish somebody would help us. Help us. Help us.
Do you hear that?
I think we're needed.
Captain Antic, can you help me?
Antic skate boots.
Reckless wheels.
I wish somebody would help us. Help us.
It's okay, guys. I've got this one.
Wow! It's the dump!